Kent in Reno's up next in Nevada on Immaculate Heart Radio. That's 9:20 a.m. Hello, Kent. You're on the air.
Hello, Dr. Hahn.
Kent, how are you doing?
Great. How are you doing?
Good. Thanks for calling.
Hey, I just have a quick question. At least I think it is. I recently, for Christmas, received something I've always wanted, and it was an old family Bible. And in it, it states explicitly that hence Catholics are forbidden to read Protestant versions of the Scriptures. Now, is that something that's changed that I just missed, or are you aware of any statement of that force?
I would have to look at the dating of that scripture, because it sounds like it's a reprint of an old Catholic Bible that might go back, you know, several decades.
Yeah, it's a 50s Bible, 1950. It's from the Catholic Press in Chicago, Illinois, and it was given to my parents for a wedding anniversary back in the 50s. So
right.
In the front, it's got some... you know, like, why do Catholics, why should they read the Bible, blah, 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 and then it's got how do Catholics and Protestants differ and stuff, and then it has
well, Kent, it's a valid question. So even if the thing is no longer legally binding in the strictest sense, it still is prudent wisdom. And so I would say this, that when Protestants evangelize Catholics, they don't use Catholic Bibles, they use their own Bible, and that's
sure.
Fine. So when Catholics evangelize Protestants, we ought to use our own Bible, and why? Because our Bible has seven books that theirs lacks, and so
right.
We might want to prepare ourselves to explain why we have those seven books and
right.
Why it is that Jesus and all the New Testament writers were quoting from the Greek translation of the Old Testament known as the Septuagint. And all scholars, even Protestants, agree that the so-called Septuagint, that is the Greek Old Testament, included the seven books that Protestants exclude. I would just say if it was good enough for the New Testament writers, it's good enough for us as Catholic Christians. But in any case, I think it is a prudent policy to use the Catholic Bible that has been approved by the bishops and to share, again, you know, on the basis of friendship and just to share in the context of joy and how it is the truth that we're sharing is what we've been experiencing.
Kent in Reno, thanks for the call. This puts in mind of the pious Anglican lady who said, you know, the King James English, if it was good enough for St. Paul, it should be good enough for us. You know?